It's a strange irony that on the one hand, we have been successful in eliminating various diseases. But at the same time, there has been a proliferation of the most dreaded disease in the world, which is cancer. I distinctly remember that about 20 to 30 years ago, there'd be one case of cancer among thousands of people, and it will cause a scare. If somebody got to know that somebody's got cancer, we were very scared. Today, you can find a cancer patient in every third or fourth or fifth household. It's not as if the disease has become less serious. It's just that it has become so common that we've gotten used to it. It is playing havoc with our country. It's playing havoc with our society. And we are not even aware why it is happening. We're closing our eyes to the reality. Certain causes are well known. We well know that excessive drinking causes liver cancer. We're also aware that excessive smoking causes cancer. Incidentally, we should talk about it. The cigarette industry resisted this well-known fact for decades. There was research that smoking is bad, but they were saying that the proof is inconclusive. So it went on right up to 1955 or even 1960 that cigarette doesn't cause cancer. In exactly the same way, there are certain other problems which are leading to this virtual epidemic of cancer, and we do it on a regular basis innocently because we do not know that this can also be a cause. So we should understand the mechanism. We all have cancer cells. Our body replicates its cells, and after a certain number of replications, the original cell becomes useless. It has to be removed, and it has a suicide gene. It has to die. If it refuses to die, then it is potentially cancerous. And we all have such cells, and those are called cancer without disease. If we do certain activities which switch off this suicide gene, due to which the natural death of these cells doesn't take place, every such activity is cancer causing. They accumulate, the number increases, and then they become full-blown disease. How do we do that? Through our regular day-to-day lifestyle eating habits. You see, whatever we eat or drink is supposed to be eliminated from our digestive system within one day. Anything which stays in the system for more than one day is potentially cancerous. Without realizing this, we have changed our eating habits so drastically that food can stay not only more than a day, but it can stay on for weeks and even months inside our system. It rots and brings about a drastic defect in our whole body. But we stick to only two things, cigarette and drinking. No. Many people get cancer even without that. Of course, one of the reasons is the use of insecticides and pesticides to a great extent. But at the same time, what we have to realize is that we cannot stop eating just because some insecticides and pesticides are being used. Of course, it will be a good habit to have organically grown fruits and vegetables. But we are missing out on something much more important. You see, this care about the use of insecticide and pesticide is so strong that some people have stopped using fruits and veggies. They should understand that when these things are poured over fruits and vegetables, only 1% of that goes into the fruit or the vegetable. 99% of that goes into your environment, into your air, your water and your soil. So there's so much of scare about this 1%. How about the other chemicals? You have to eat only two things. Either it has to be vegetarian or it has to be non-vegetarian. Now the problem with non-vegetarian food or the animal-based food is that if there is one part of any chemical in that environment, by the time it goes into this flesh of this animal, it can have 1,000 times accumulation of those chemicals. Supposing a river or a ocean has one part of mercury, then the fish that grows in that can have as much as 1,000 times more mercury than is present in the water. So you have to be very careful about the use of insecticides and pesticides. In any case, even if these chemicals are not being used, excessive consumption of non-vegetarian food is bad for us. There's an international organization called World Cancer Research Fund, which monitors the incidence of cancer all over the world. And they have quantified it that as the consumption of meat increases in a society, the incidence of cancer also multiplies. After seeing this direct correlation, they have issued guidelines about how much red meat to use. And that quantity happens to be only 75 grams per person per day. Even our mobile phone is twice as heavy. Since we are not aware, most people consume as much as 300 grams of meat at one sitting. So for God's sake, do not use too much of it, especially when it is contaminated by chemicals also. So be predominantly vegetarian, even if not pure vegetarian. And even if there's a use of chemicals, there are ways to set it right. A few simple things can take care of this problem. The first precaution is that whatever fruits and vegetables you buy, it should be properly washed in water. Never ever take any fruit and vegetables without washing it thoroughly. It'll be much better if you add some common salt into this water and soak your fruits and vegetables in that for about half an hour. Even better would be the use of vinegar, not the synthetic variety, but normal vinegar. Add vinegar to your water and soak all your fruits and vegetables into that. That will take care of that. And if you are even more careful, it will be better to use potassium permanganate, which is known as Lal Dawai in India. Earlier it was used in well water. So keep some potassium permanganate with you, add that to the water and then soak all your fruits and vegetables in that for about 30 minutes. The only additional precaution is that then this chemical should also be properly washed out of the fruits and vegetables. Such small steps would be enough to get rid of most of the problems. But at the same time, be very particular that you don't let you or your family members to have constipation. It's not as if you have a constipation today and tomorrow you're going to have cancer. But if you let it linger on for all your life, then you are increasing the chances of getting cancer. Eat healthy, exercise healthy, the right lifestyle is enough safeguard against this dreaded disease, which has been increasing. The processed food has played a major role in this. So use that only as a treat, which you can utilize once in a fortnight. But this culture of having every meal from the market is leading to this virtual epidemic of cancer. The simple lifestyle that we lead can take us back to the situation where it used to be a very rare occurrence. We deserve to go back to that. So much of situation getting so bad when you have full so-called cancer trains going from Punjab to some places in Rajasthan for treatment is just not acceptable.